rotate on, there we go, rotate on that axis. Okay, so the rear body grab, there are so many things. I actually have smaller versus larger opponent. I have an entire thing on how to get out when a large person grabs you. And I'm talking, we got some 6'3 guys working on it. We've got Dave, who's just a massive bear of a guy, grabbing these two and throwing them around, and how to escape from that and how to work that. So I'm gonna show it on her first. So when you're caught like this, one of the first things you've got to do is you've got to get a good base. Now, a lot of our training, we train the base like crazy so that even before you get to this position, you, as soon as somebody touches you, you're already engaging the base mechanics. It's how we develop this. Just in case you wanted to know, we've got Marco in Germany. He's the associate instructor out there for Core JKD. Keep this wrapping, please. So Marco in Germany, if you want to advance through Core JKD training and you happen to be in that area, he can actually train you to levels for testing in Core JKD, CJKD Weapons, Rebel Wing Chun. Just to let you know, that is available. And he's a great resource. If you're out there, he's the man to train with. On a body wrap, when we have a body wrap like this, one of the first things is to make sure you don't get picked up. So it's like the kid that doesn't want to be picked up. Literally, you just kind of scrunch down and it makes it really difficult. So have somebody lift you up if they're heavy, and then you do that center of gravity drop. But the key on that is, as soon as somebody tries to go from lifting to taking you down, you have to enact to get that back into play. And you've got to be able to go an up and down mechanic on that based on this type of pressure. It's trainable. So she starts lifting up, I drop down, I don't want to be picked up. I'm the kid that is just doesn't want to be lifted up, right? So as she lifts up, I drop down, and I'm immediately thinking it's making it hard. This is hard for anybody to do. As soon as you start putting that mentality in there, and if you imagine, if you actually take your brain, you start visualizing hooking your feet into metal stirrups or into metal footrests or something that are grounded to the earth, that are bolted to the earth. And if you do that, this is my mentality change right now. So I'm putting my mind in that mechanic where my brain is going into visually imagining that my feet are hooked into something that's hooked into the stone right now. So when she picks me up, this is the thing, yeah. So there is a slight difference. You can feel the struggling on her body trying to lift me up. Now other people will say, oh, get a big guy in there. I've done this to big guys. I have people here who are, I'm demonstrating this with, because women don't get shown enough as capable human beings. If you want to sit there and watch sweaty men, you go to a sweaty man channel and enjoy. I'm not judging. Take all the pleasure you want in that. These are tough women. Women can train in this. We need to show more of this. And this is what I've been doing for a very long time. All of the stuff I do comes from me working with people far bigger and stronger than I am. That's how I developed this. That's why I know this stuff works. If you have a question about it, either do the training and test it for yourself under the conditions that I speak, hear all the words that I say, or go somewhere else. There's other channel. You can watch Sweaty Men on another channel and you're okay. Plenty of them. Go. In this, so you've got part of that taken care of, is that up. So she lifts up, I drop down, okay, does my hip. Now say she goes to the ground. As soon as she starts to go, she's gonna lift me up and then she's gonna try and take me down. See? So I have to immediately get into my stance where I'm a squatting stance, bent knee phasic is what it is. I'm gonna go on the balls of the feet a little bit more. So she lifts me up, trying to lift me up. I'm going from that position. Now she drops me and goes to there. I get into position to where now I am stabilized this way. And on the fly, she'll pick up again, and then I'll just start to drop, just like that. So that's something that you can train over and over again so that you start developing that sense for when this wraps around your body, you're getting a sense for that uplift and then the drop, the uplift and the drop. And those are indicators for you to enact the training, the stabilization and the mechanics. The other thing, now we're working the kinjit position. Now she's in here, she's hipping in. So this is hip in. So when she brushes up against me like that, for somebody who's lighter and having to lift somebody who's heavier, this is what you want to do. She's posting her foot in properly so that she can drive her hips into me as she leverages me up. and off of her hip. So that's how that works. She does this well, so that's why she's going in this position. Now, somebody who's really a big bear of a person, and I've had many of these people, they don't always have to do that. But if you want to do it where you don't blow out your back or use excessive energy or your resources, this is how you do it. You set the foot into play, you hip in just like that, so that she's actually elevating my center of gravity, and then she's going to leverage tight in here and then leverage me off of her hips and up, okay? That's how you do that. All of this stuff has to come in before you start doing the other training. Now, I'm not gonna go fully into the Kinjit, but I'm gonna show you what it is. I've got a lot of videos, 600, 700 videos on there. You'll find it. One of the things is I need to square up to my attacker. I cannot stay with her at my back or him at my back. It doesn't matter what, it's all I know is it's a physical attacker. So one of the main things I have to do is get this hand down in this area. I'm not gonna worry about trying to go for groin strikes. It's a waste of time. I need to do something that's going to physically and mechanically turn me back into the opponent. So if this leg happens to be forward, because it's a big guy that's just lifting you up and things like that, they may have that leg there as well. And you can't rotate properly. What you do is you drop your hand down, you hook underneath here, you use your fingers, you use your wrist, and then you use your elbow. All of those come into play so that your hip drops back, and then you regain position to the next leg as you step back here into a Kinjit position. Now the entire time is I'm going to try and seal this so the person can't get away. I don't want them to be able to release. So if she's not like that, she's hipping in, she's doing it properly, all I have is one leg to worry about. But the main thing is I have to get my hip off that line. If that hip is still in here, it's going to be a problem for me. So sometimes I may need to lift up a little bit on the shoulders. So I create that space, drop, set the hip, hand into the hip. I'm doing a little snake just like that. And then I rotate it over so that I have this kind of movement. This is a stronger position. You don't want to go back like this. You can if you have, that's the only option. But once you get in here and you turn this over, you've got a lot more leverage force that you can press against because you're gaining distance. And if you're like this, you don't have as much distance. If you have your fingertips, you have a lot more range. So as this occurs, I'm going to create a little bit of space. As I'm doing that, this hand goes back here and I step back. Now I've got this in play at the same time as grabbing this. I'm doing these one at a time. You'll do them simultaneously. A lot of them will come together at the same time. You grab here. Again, this is the rotation. This is the Kinjit part. I don't care too much about this. I can still use it to lift and rotate them outward. But I'm going to squat. My back is going to be a little bit more vertical. She's already feeling the imbalance. I've got this here, and all I'm going to do is rotate my upper body. Because I am holding her here, she can't get away. She can't break fall. So I keep this tight. I rotate like that and turn her out. So we get wrapped like this right off the bat. We've got to sit there and start inserting at the same time as I'm grabbing here. So now these are occurring more in real time. So she comes in and wraps, boom. My first instinct is to get to here, right there. And I've bound this already. Now I'm at this point. I can lift up as I rotate, and I'm going to be nice because I don't want to slam her into some stone. I don't care if this is the street. This is what happens to the person who's attacking you. You grab and you hold. That little motion on the upper body torques and turns them. Say her hands are down because that's an uncomfortable, bad position. So she uses both of those, and I'm holding fairly tightly. She's gonna bind that so I can't get away. She's gonna squat and straighten her back out a little bit more. Now that starts tilting me in the wrong position, or tilts me in a bad position for me. Now she starts to work the little upper body rotation as she squats down a little bit more. Upper body rotation and just rotate under, there we go, rotate on that axis. It works for her, it works for me, it works for whomever you're doing this to. You have to test it against larger people to understand that you may have to finesse the legs a little bit more. If I'm stepping in here, that means you may have to start working that leverage system a little bit more. One thing that she does really well is because she's trained this, is slips the hips out right off the bat. You've got to rotate the hips and get that into play. Then she's got to bind my arms because That's the part that keeps me tight to her upper torso. If she's also your mentality, like the Kinjit is in here, you're working in this position, you've got the person put off to that side and you're rotating like that. If you think of that column, centerline column, and you're rotating off here, you're not going to make it difficult on yourself, on your musculature or anything else. So you're getting in there, it's the upper body that's rotating. So think of this as rotating here. You don't want it to be like this, and I put the arms out like that so you can see the discrepancy, the large angles that are created by somebody who's doing it improperly. Okay, so you're going to go from here and it's like that, and it's that squatting position, that's really where it's at. That's where this is. So I'm coming in through here and I've got this. She's got to bind and really secure that. Yes, good body posture. Yes, there we go. And we go. So it works. It's something that, again, you have to do over and over again. You've got to test this, not just sit there and say, oh, that'll never work. You don't know whether it works or not unless you're actually doing it. And if you're not doing it properly, no, it won't work. But all of the other things I showed you beforehand really matter. That means listening to somebody coming into play so that they can't get in on you. So that's part of your awareness of surroundings. Visually, if you don't have that, you have auditory, especially off the sound of these rocks and whatever environment you happen to be in. Make sure your mind in some other area that is not your house or your home is on the surroundings. Don't be so up into here that you forget what's going on around you. It's not about training in fear, living in fear. It's about crossing the street. You look both ways before you cross the street. You don't live in fear you're going to get run over by a car, right? Okay, it's the same thing. I step into an environment that is not mine, that I have no control over, that I don't know that the world could be there, anybody. I put my mind on the present situation, my location. Pay attention to that. That makes it a little bit more difficult for somebody to sneak up and start an assault on you, because you'll get time. Time is really the key here. So work smart, use all your senses. Don't be staggering, too fatigued or drunk or your mind on something else. Don't put yourself in a position that you know could be dangerous. Just pull it down to the mentality that I am here, I am present, I am in control of me. Anything that comes to me has to get through this barrier called my senses. And then as soon as they touch me, I get another line of mechanism, another line of functionality that they then have to beat too. Okay.